49, a child slides down a hill, 28 degree incline, and at the bottom, her speed is precisely half what it would have been if the slide had been frictionless. Calculate the coefficient of kinetic friction between the slide and the child. This is actually pretty similar to your ramp problem with the Hot Wheels cars, where you've compared the actual time to predicted times, and the difference must be due to friction. Now, just to let you know, on the AP physics test, you'll never have this kind of problem where they take it to the kinematics and compare the two velocities like you're seeing in this problem. So the main thing I want you to focus on is free body diagrams, topic sentences. And if you get that far and you get it, that's awesome. So let's start with that. Force net is down, and we're going to deal with it with friction being there first. Mass times acceleration is force down plus the negative force friction up. And let me close this box so I can get this page up. So again, the moneymaker, mg sine theta is down minus the friction force, umg cosine theta. And then if you look at masses drop out in each term. So this is a great place to get it to. Acceleration is equal to the driving force, g sine theta, minus the friction force, mu g cosine theta. Now, what they're saying is v final with friction will be half that without friction. And so if you use your big three, I went ahead and thought it'd help you out a little bit. But it's the square root of 2 times acceleration times the distance. Since the distance is the same, this is the right equation to use. The times will be different. So the acceleration without friction is right here. So if you just go acceleration is equal to g sine theta, put that in there, and then this, you might as well make up the velocity here could be just, or distance here could be 1. It doesn't say how far the sledding hill is. And so you might as well just make this 1. And you can actually get your V final. And then, here, when we actually solve for acceleration with friction, we're going to have to use this term. The only thing we don't know is this coefficient of friction. But we can put all this term, dump it in right here. Okay, and then we can set the two terms equal to each other. This velocity is exactly half of the first velocity that you solve for. And then you're going to have to square things, get rid of square roots, and then do some algebra to isolate mu. But I'm telling you, you've done a good job if you've gotten it to this level. All right, good luck.